Some of you lived your life by the standards of this world, but you couldn't go all the way. Yes, you sinned, and yes, you were in some pretty bad predicaments. All of us were. But something kept bringing you back, and out of that way, you always desired something else. Even when you were in sin, you ultimately desired something else. And you had those days, and you had those nights, where you were saying in your heart, Lord, I'm sorry. You knew you were messing up, but you did abide in darkness, and you were not alive. You were trying to find life. Is what you were doing. You can't really call that being alive. We can say, because of who we are, that was really death, because there was no way out. Despite the fun that you had and everything else, there was a great emptiness. Most people, when they come to Christ, they forget about that great emptiness they had prior to coming to Christ. They forget about the days where they simply mourned for things that they couldn't obtain. And I'm not talking about tangible things. I'm talking about spiritual things. Sometimes we forget how in-depth that darkness was and how badly we wanted out of that darkness. But we didn't know how to get out of it. Everything was confusing in our minds. We would take every opportunity to get rid of the stress in many different ways because of the darkness. We forget that. That's just like an alcoholic may forget the reasons he began to drink in the first place, because it was a dark place they were in. And the alcohol gave them a portion of a dream world that was a release from that darkness, but it didn't last too long. And so they end up chasing that first time they truly felt good, and they can never obtain that again. So they become an alcoholic, and now they're physically dependent on this thing. Now they're double stuck in that darkness. Marijuana is the same thing. In truth, most people make up pains and things to get marijuana, because marijuana can make you forget about the sting of life. And you escape it through a dream. You call that getting high or buzzed or something like that. Call it a dream. It's a dream. Because once that high, once that buzz is over, you're back to reality. You're back in the darkness. And you say, oh, I need another. And another and another. And you always have a hope that you're going to escape your present day life. That's what happens when you try to live by bread alone. It doesn't work out too well, and you end up abiding in death. Therefore, Jesus said, it is written, man shall not live by bread alone. And you can't live by bread alone. We've tried that before. It does not work. But listen to this. There's a comma, and it says, but by every word that proceedeth out of the mouth of God. Now, the words that came out of the mouth of God were spoken by the prophets. A prophet is a person who speaks the words of the Lord. So you have the prophets, and you have the apostles. And of course, you have Jesus of Nazareth, who is the Word of God made flesh and dwelt among men. So you have those three components, and this is what we read called the Bible. We read the words of the prophets. We read the words of Jesus. We read the words of the apostles. And you carry the gospel of Jesus Christ. So when the Holy Spirit is working in you, you're not speaking your own words. You're speaking the words of Jesus, which in fact come from the Father. Because the Holy Spirit was sent in the name of Jesus for your sakes, for my sake. The Holy Spirit is the Spirit of God that poured out on all flesh. So when you start living by the Word of God, all of a sudden you don't need the alcohol. Though you may be addicted to it, you find yourself not needing it. You don't need to escape the world. You begin to face the world. Why? Because you have more and more life in you. When you believe upon the words of Jesus, and you have a born-again spirit, that becomes your identity. No longer is your identity flesh. That's why Paul said, you are no longer flesh, but spirit. And in the context of that reading, it's for those who believe upon the word, because what you believe you're living by, and what you live by, you in fact believe. Paul said that. Paul said, you're no longer flesh, but you are spirit. He said that because your identity is no longer that identity that was born of your mother and your daddy, that came down through some genealogy. Doesn't matter if you were adopted or not, you came from somebody. That's not your identity anymore. Your identity, who you are, how God sees you, is brand new. Thus, a new creature in Christ. You can only be a new creature in Christ. Otherwise, you're part of the walking dead, which is the world. That's why they don't progress. That's why they advertise technology so much. Like, we have gone so far, yet we're still paying for everything. That's not growth. That's putting new wrapping paper over the same box. because you're still boxed in with the world. That's all the world does, is they invent new wrapping papers. They present it a different way to every single generation, but it's the same old thing. You're gonna pay for everything. There is no freedom. The world's freedom is, so long as you agree with us, you're free for a moment. But that's not guaranteed. That depends upon leadership, and if it changes, you may go back into bondage again. There's no freedom in the world. It's a mind game. It's something that men dwell in that keeps them engaged and occupied, while Satan continues to deteriorate the souls of many. Remember, Satan is here, killing, stealing, and destroying. That's what he does. That's all he does. We have been delivered from that, endless cycle of death. The just shall live by faith. Romans 1:17, we know this. When his word becomes part of us, that can only happen by your belief. Your belief is, in fact, the faith you have in Christ. The just shall live by faith. I'm not looking for any sensation. It is by faith we receive what we receive. By faith, the just shall live by faith. Faith is more than a word, more than just believing. Faith is living, it's an action. Faith is doing deeds. In other words, when you live by Christ, then what you do in your life is by the word of God, by the words of Yeshua HaMashiach. And when you do those things of the Lord, you can only do so by faith. Once they become part of you, you begin to live like that, you are alive spiritually. And you stand upright by faith, so long as you're here. Once you're reunited with the Lord, it won't require faith. Right now requires faith. Whatever we do in this world for the Lord, we do so by faith, not by proof, by faith. That's why so many don't trust the Lord. They don't trust his resolve, and so they take out their sword, their weapons. They have their own tactics that they utilize against other folks. But if you live by faith, you know that Christ is alive in us, and that's why we're alive. Jesus, his life, is in us, causing us to be alive. As Jesus is one with the Father, so he prayed that we may be one with him, that we may be one with the Father also. He prayed this prayer. And if we're one with the Father, we're not living by our own power, but by the power of the living God. And because Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life, then we must have Christ in us. And if Christ be in us, that means we are living by his word. That means we believe his word. We have become one with his word, not humanity's word, the words of Christ. And then we operate, we engage, we communicate, we do all those things with the word right there, with Christ right there. It is though you live your life with Jesus walking right beside you. How many of you would watch the same movies you watch with Jesus right beside you? How many of you would have the same conversations you have with everybody with Jesus right beside you? How many of you would do half the things you do with Jesus right beside you? How many of you would sit there and worry if the King of Kings and Lord of Lords was right beside you? You wouldn't. The just shall live by faith. Faith in what? Faith in Christ Jesus. What is Christ Jesus? He is the Word of God. So our faith, our trust in the Word of God, if we live by that, then it's not our power anymore. It is the power of the Word of God that's operating in our lives. For though he was crucified through weakness, yet he liveth by the power of God. For we also are weak in him, but we shall live with him by the power of God toward you. 2 Corinthians 13:4. He was crucified through weakness, yet he liveth by the power of God. Same thing goes for us. Can't you see that what Jesus did in this earth, he really did for us? The model of our lives, that is held within Christ. We are weak in him, which means we cannot sustain everything by ourselves. We don't have the power. We are too weak. But if he lives in us and we live with him, which we do, then it's the power of God that will sustain all of us through Christ. So we're not standing upright by our own power, but we're being propped up. Thank you, Lord. We have an initial measure of faith. To utilize that faith is to be honest with yourself. You cannot lie to yourself, nor can you be greedy. Faith never works with the greedy. Faith never works with the prideful. Faith only works for the humble. In other words, you start where you are with what you believe, and you believe that little bit that you believe, and you do so with all of what you are. Not everything, just that small thing. When you do that, the Lord will begin to exercise that faith in you. It's going to be challenged. When it's challenged, if you truly have utilized that little tiny piece of faith, you will still believe in the hardship. And that's when the Lord will add to you even more and even more. You see, that measure of faith he gave you is a huge measure. But all too often, we're not honest with ourselves to even utilize the speck of that measure. We continue to look to everybody else to believe in Jesus. He gave you an initial measure of faith. You believe in him a little bit. Well, with that little bit that you believe in him all the way. Bring it into your daily life. We totally ignore what the Lord has given us. And we start looking for the big stuff, trying to show somebody else that we are still the old competition thing. There is no competition among the saints. And do you know there's no difference between a small measure of faith and a big measure of faith? The only way you can ever know that is to begin to utilize the little bitty tiny faith the Lord has given you and to be honest with it. Apply it to every aspect of your life. And then he will begin to unlock the rest. He'll work in you to unlock the rest. And don't seek man for everything. Stop getting everything secondhand. Often we pray for the Lord for an answer, but we will have no deed behind it. Faith without works is dead. I am crucified with Christ. Nevertheless, I live. Crucified means killed. It means you're dead as a doorknob, right? It means you were killed. We too are killed with Christ. Nevertheless, we live. But it's not us who are alive, but Christ lives in us. And the life which we now live in the flesh, we live by the faith of the Son of God who loves us, who gave himself for us, Galatians 2:20. Do you see the keys of living? And what do we live by? By Christ. By faith in the Son of God, which is by Christ. So we're not alive unto ourselves, nor do we live unto ourselves. We don't pick something to live by. We can only live. Beginning with a small measure of faith, we are dependent upon the Lord. All these decisions we have made for ourselves in this life, how far did they really get you? Think about it. How far did they get you in your faith? Only becoming a good steward over what the Lord has already given us will he increase us. He's not going to increase any of us outside of his own principles. He won't do it. You know what that means? Your situation is not dead. That means your situation is not a lost cause. That means you got to go back to the basics. Begin to obey the Lord in the simplicity of what you can believe right now. That's all that means. What you thought was gone is not gone. What you think is a lost cause is not a lost cause. You've got to begin. And I found out in my own life, you can know everything there is to know about the Word. That doesn't mean you have began living as a new creature. Even Satan knows the Word better than we. He is not a new creature. He's condemned. Begin with those small things. So now we know how to live by something. Not by the souls, but we live by faith of the Son of God, Jesus of Nazareth. We walk by faith, by our belief, our sincere belief in the Word of God who is Christ Jesus.